All right, guys, we are now going to perform oil change number 8 on the Forester XT. I'm going to continue with what I have been using for the Forester XT, which is the Motul 540 XS. And we're also going to take a look at the Motive Tools oil funnel, which I have not even tested yet for this Subaru. And standard Subaru oil filter, of course. Let's go ahead and get this going. Let me start by getting under the car and taking a look here, get familiar. I haven't changed Subaru oil in quite a while. Ooh, and I'm on a linear, not wide view. So we'll try it for this video maybe, see how it is. Normally I do wide view for a bigger experience, but maybe this will be more detailed. Let's try it out. Wow, so this is a trifecta of Forester videos today. Remember, the best thing the Forester got recently in the last year is these Michelin AS All Season. Are these the AS Plus? I don't know. I thought they were, but I wonder if they're not. Maybe these aren't even the tires I thought they were. I don't know. I thought these are supposed to be high performance all season, but I'm not used to seeing the word Premier right there. I mean, they're on now, too bad, but I wonder if I actually didn't get the tires I thought. I wanted the AS Plus, you know, the real good ones. How would I have not noticed that? How weird. Premiers. I almost think the Premiers are a step down, which would really suck, because these were expensive. These were like 800 bucks or something. All right, now I'm just trying to find... Oh my god, it's been so long since I've under here. It's such a mess under here. I gotta find the frickin' drain plug. Where is that thing hiding? I wonder if I do usually take off one of these covers to do this. I probably do. That's just sad that it's been so long since I've done a Forester oil change that I can barely remember how to do it. All right. I'm gonna take off the cover just to get familiar with it and inspect stuff anyway. I'm hot. So I'm gonna do a 10 mil and a flathead, pry out some of those clips, take off one cover in the bottom there and see where we are. All right, guys, I'm gonna cancel that lower tray removal as I was kind of just going in on the wrong side. And I did see it. Can you see it up there? There it is, right in front of us. And I was just looking at a bad angle, that's all. So I don't have to take off any covers to do this. Let me go ahead and get this thing started. Looks like I have a safety clip on it also. I'll get this all draining and then we'll just go up to the top and do a few things too. Super easy with the Fumoto valve. A few seconds, move your clip. And you're good to go. All right, next thing I'll do here is break loose the oil filter. There we go. Just let some air drain out of that for a minute before we look at that Motive funnel here. One sec. All right, so first off, a big thanks to Motive Tools for sending this funnel for sampling for the Subaru. They sent this sample out. So, this looks like an adapter piece and the funnel, the top that they all have. You've seen Motive funnels on my channel before. Let's get these out here. So it's a standard system where a lot of these for different cars will have the funnel, your middleman, and a possible adapter sometimes. So let me get these open real quick. All right. So first, we'll take the middleman and go into the top. It seats very solid once it's in. Now, of course, this is much too small. So let's go ahead, let me get this set up. Get you set up with the adapter. This cool adapter here with a rubber gasket on all sides. See that? Super tight. It even looks like a Subaru cap. That is sweet. Oh man, that is beautiful. Rock solid, super secure. You don't have to worry about holding your funnel with your hand, you know, which I've done my whole life. Ready for the new oil filter once I fill it up, but I do want to let the drain finish first. So this looks like it's going to work good. We'll actually watch this and watch that oil go in. That'll be pretty cool too. Let's have a peek down here, see how this oil's coming. Oh, okay. Probably about time to stop it. It's just stopped to a drip here. I mean, I'll get a little bit more, but that's pretty much all I'd really do. You're never going to get every drop. It would probably drip for hours if you really let it. So let me go ahead and get to the next step here. All right. I don't remember if I told you, but this is a 6,500-mile oil change. Still has some clarity to it. Not too bad. You can see through it. It's not black. And to be honest, if I were to do Blackstone tests or a different type of oil test, I could probably run this 10,000 if I had to. But, you know, I don't like to push it. I already waited an extra 1,000 from when I was originally going to do the oil here. Finally, just learning to not waste quite so much money. So I was going to do it at 55, and I said, come on, the car just gets babied, and it's good oil. I can save a little money. It's probably a 10,000 interval oil change for all. This oil probably easily lasts 10,000 with people that get reports on it. So I'm still wasting a little money, but you know, I want to keep the oil super fresh in this thing. It's got to last us a good couple more years. We're at, let's see, what are we at? Almost 40,000 miles on this car. That's pretty high for me. I don't see any oil drips anywhere on the ground. I might look under there, but that usually doesn't go too well for me. But no drips, you know, nothing major, which is good. You know, I'm barely past 36,000. I got to get all the warranty things straight and see what's 30. I think the powertrain is probably 60,000. So maybe the body stuff is 36, whatever that is. So I'm out of warranty on a bunch of stuff, bottom line. I have an extended warranty for the CVT paperwork that I got for something or other. I'm not sure what it was. I remember just in the last 3 months, I got some kind of CVT paperwork. I don't think it was a recall, but it was just a T8 extended warranty or something. So anyway, the car's running great, so I don't know. Still wondering about those damn tires. I wonder if I got the wrong damn tires. All right. I mean, the tires handle good. Whatever. Fumoto is closed. I'm going to fill up the oil filter with oil. Then we'll go ahead and watch some Motive funnel porn and watch the oil glug, glug, glug into its new home. Hold on a sec. All right, guys, we are about to do a full send of 5 liters. I already put a dribble into the oil filter, and let's take a look at what this looks like going through the bad Oscar. Oh, look at that. Look at that porn. It actually pours so quick, I can't really fill it up. Man, looks like beer, looks like apple juice. Man, that's a lot of oil. Man, it's so much easier buying the jug, not having to open 5 or 6 quarts like I used to do. Drain each one into the next. Oh my God, so much like labor. 1 5-quart and you're done. Now, a lot of people just use a 5-quart and literally they're done. Look how stiff, I mean, no, that's gonna fall, it's gonna bite me. Look how stable, how strong the oil funnel is. It's solid, it's like a piece of the car. But still, I wouldn't trust this oil to balance on it. All right. Beautiful, look at that. Look at that shot right there. Sweet. Okay, I'm gonna let this drain for a bit. Funnel works just like it should. No leaks, super clean action. Still 99, maybe 85 degrees, feels like 90. I'm still getting, probably gonna start wetting through my shirt pretty soon. Yeah, I'm wearing a shirt. Whew. Oh man, all right. Finally glad that third video of the day is over. I might've made one last night actually, but I am just tired out. Too bad none of them are for the GTI. I also washed the Forester today after its big road trip and got all the bugs off it and everything. I need to scrub those tires that are brown and get the mud out of them, but it's too hot today to even get into a super detail. So I just did a basic wash. That thing still looks pretty dang, pretty good paint, huh? Not too bad. I was looking at both reflections side by side, trying to figure out like which one was a little cooler. I don't know, there's that crystal white pearl in the Subarus. I think I know that I like it more than the pure white. If I had to choose one. And it's not just because of my WRX, I literally just like a creamier pearl white more than just white, which is just a little bit more plain, you know? That's what it is. And this has a little crystal in it. Whew, all right. Let me get this buckled up, finished up, fill out my logbook for oil change number 8, and I can be done with this and get on with my life. We have a WWE pay-per-view tonight. You just subscribe and you get all the pay-per-views free. It's a good deal. 10, 15 bucks a month, whatever it is. Every pay-per-view free. If you didn't have this, it'd be like 50, I don't know, 40, 50, 60 bucks, whatever it is, a piece. So, I mean, we watch enough WWE in the house that we pay that monthly fee and get all the pay-per-views free. So that's coming up soon. I got to get inside the house and start having a good time. So thanks for joining me. I'm running out of steam, as you can tell. Thanks for joining me for oil change number 8. I might have said 7. This is oil change number 8. Everything documented in the book, piece by piece by piece by piece. And that's how it'll always be until we get rid of this car. We do probably got at least 2 years more payments on it, so it's not going anywhere soon. It'd be nice just for once in our goddamn lives to pay off the car fully and only have one car payment for a little while. But a lot of times that doesn't work. The car will get old in a couple more years. This car will be pretty old, probably be leaky, probably have little things, a lot more annoyances with it. And, you know, then we may think about looking for to see what's next on her side of the park. For me, I'm stuck for a good 3 years, maybe 4 years with this one until I'm ready, until I'm financially set to move into something different. Anyway, I'll see you guys later. It's been a long week. Forgot one thing to let you know the parts for your Motive funnel if you do want to get one of these things. The top is like universal. All of them are the same. So don't worry about your blue piece. And this is if you can't find a kit, then you could buy these stuff individually. So your middle part is a 2303. I know you can't really see it too well. 2303. And they have like 2101. 2301, 2302, 2303. This is 2303 for the correct bottom splines. And then you would get the Subaru adapter, which goes right in the bottom. And between the three different types I have in my garage, I could probably cover most cars now. Any car I get, probably one of those combinations is gonna work. So we'll find out next car I get. So anyway, I'll throw a link in there for the Motive tools in case you do, starting to drip, in case you do want to look into a Motive funnel, just nice to have, and it's probably a lifetime funnel. I did clean it all off, wipe it all off between each one. I don't want to get all nasty and collect dirt. So that's about it. See you later.